Life, and I give it glory. I give it glory. I give it. the fourth chapter, James, my middle name, 4, verse 13 through 16. And the Proverbs, chapter 3, verses 5 and 6, and Proverbs 4 and 7 for our hearing today. He that has an ear, let them hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. And we plan to be somewhat brief. James 4, 13 through 16, Sister Jesse Brooks. Is our reader today of the Holy Word from the King James Version of the Scripture. Read.
Go to now. Ye that say.
You that say.
Today or tomorrow.
You that say today or tomorrow.
We will go into such a city.
We will do such a thing, go to a certain city.
And continue there a year.
And we're going to stay there 1 year.
And buy and sell.
And we're going to buy this and we're going to sell that.
And get gain.
And we're going to gain. We're going to prosper.
Whereas ye know not what shall be on the morrow.
But listen, you really don't know what shall be on tomorrow.
For what is your life?
For consider this. For what is your life?
It is even a vapor.
Your life is just like a vapor.
That appeared for a little time.
That it just appears, you just live for a short time.
And then vanisheth away.
And then I will disappear.
Mm-hmm. For that ye ought to say.
But this is how you ought to plan. This is how you ought to say. This is what you should say. When you want to do something, don't make plans without this. Mm-hmm. You should say,
if the Lord will.
If the Lord will.
We shall live.
If the Lord want this, we will be alive.
And do this
and
or
then,
that.
Then we will go to the city and we will sell or we will do that if the Lord said so.
Mm-hmm. But now ye rejoice in your boastings.
But you are that will plan things without God. You are rejoicing in your own saying.
All such rejoicing is evil.
And all of that rejoicing, he says, is evil. Before she read that next script, plan how you're going to spend your income tight. Without the Lord. I just use that so you can get it. Don't make no plans without first acknowledging God. Let's go to the Proverbs and see what he said. Proverbs 3, verses 5 and 6. What it says?
Trust in the Lord with all thy heart.
Now, trust in the Lord with all of your heart.
And lean not unto thine own understanding.
Are y'all with me? And lean, don't even lean that way you are understanding or thinking it. Don't even consider doing what you're thinking in your life, that I have made tragic errors. I made mistakes that I'm paying for now. For making plans and carrying it out without acknowledging God. To acknowledge God in a plan does not mean that you just invite God in and then tell God what you want. It means to let God be the leader in what you plan.
Amen.
Make sure you get that right, because a lot of you got the scripture twisted. When he said, in all thy ways acknowledge him, and then he shall direct your path. It ain't just a knowledge that God, you see what I'm doing, and God, I want you to bless what I'm doing. God, I'm going out here and get me a car, and I'm anointed in your name. You bless me with it. Then you are the one with the knowledge. You then become the one who are in control. You are boasting about what you're going to do, but you are asking God to bless it. But in reality, what the Bible is saying, first, allow God to give you the knowledge and what to do. Acknowledge him. Give him the right of way to tell you what to do or what not to do. I wish I could preach today. And we always want God to bless whatever we're doing. But you need to ask God, what do you want me to do? Amen. That's the question. I made mistakes like that. And I'm telling you, you pay dearly for every choice that you make. For life is choices that we make. And every choice that we make, we will get the result of those choices. Amen. Whether it be for evil or good. If you make choices to do right, you're going to get the result for making the right choice. If you make a choice to do wrong, you get the result from making that choice of the wrong choice. Wrong choices cannot produce right things. Life, it consists of choices. God made man a free moral agent. Man can make the decision to serve God or to deny God. Therefore, whatever his choice is, he will get the results of that choice. If he don't want to entertain God or acknowledge God as his Lord and Savior, it is his prerogative. It is his right. It is his choice. Even though God died, that he might make the right choice.
Come on, somebody. So I come to realize that even in that moment, like Joseph, hallelujah, I could have retaliated. Yes, I wanted to pick up the phone. Yes, I wanted to get on the email. I wanted to text people. But the Lord told me to stand still, and he told me to hold my peace. He says, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Hallelujah. When you are being falsely accused, the first thing you want to do is get your name out of that mess. Come on, somebody. You want to tell your version of the story. Why does everybody else get to tell their version of the story? And God tell you, you got to stand there and
yes, sir. This song just talks about being thankful.